Okay, so now we are going to talk about full-text search in Postgres. Do you know what does it picture means? This is a Buddhist tanka. It calls the Elephant V. I bought it in Nepal, and I just like it because of the elephant and because it's teach you how to meditate, how not to follow monkey and become master of your mind. But actually, it's just a nice picture for the attraction. So 11 years ago, I and Theodore presented full text search in Toronto. So 11 years ago. And except some little development of full text search, it stayed the same. And the reason is that why we took attention to the full text search now is that we found that it becomes a bit popular solution, and people asking us about new development, new features. So we decided to make a push for this PGCon, and we would like to present our some new development, and we hope that it will be available to all people in this year. Uh-huh. So if you don't know who we are Postgres developers maybe for 20 or 15 years. Yeah, and we did all this stuff. So what we'll talk about, we will talk about why there is we need a full text search in PostgreSQL. Because people often are surprised because there are so many open source solutions, very good, like Solr, like Elasticsearch. Why bother with the full text search in database? So this is an opportunity to talk about this a bit, so you will understand why we need it. And then we very briefly summarize the full text search in Postgres features. Then we talk about full text search problem and how we solve them. So the agenda is big. So what is this a full text search? Basically, full text search is a find document with which match a query, and then sort optionally in some order. Why we say match query? Why not just say contains query? Because query can be very complex. So that's why we use word match. A typical search is a find document which contains all words from query and return them sorted by similarity to the query. This is very typical usage of full text search. So in principle, it is possible to feed database content to external search engines, which are very fast, very good developed, but they can't find all documents because we know that document in database can be not just materialized document, it can be result of some big and complex query. It is a virtual query. You can't index them. Also, external databases don't have access to attributes. So you can construct a complex full text search query. For example, I want to find something and with some another constraints. Yes. To do this, you have to feed all these attributes to the external search engine. So eventually, you can be finished with feeding all content of database to the search engine. Another reason is that this is not free to use external search engine. You have to maintain them. It is a extra headache for the system administrator. Yes. Also, there is also concern about that if we use database in some limited environment, some specific environment, you need to certify. So you have a Postgres already certified, and then you have to bother about certify open source engine. This is also extra overhead. External search engine doesn't provide instant search because we need time to download new data, index, and re-index. Also, they don't provide consistency of data. So you can find a document, but it doesn't exist already. In database, you have a fully consistent environment. Once document uploaded, inserted to the database, you can search it and you can obtain it. That's the reason we have in mind when we developed our full text search for Postgres. So the requirement is a full integration with database. That means that we should support transaction, concurrency, recovery, online indexing. Also, we wanted to provide configurability because it is impossible to in advance to say what people need. So we provide a mechanism, we provide infrastructure to let people customize search engine. And also, well, the requirement is scalability. Nobody wants very slow search engine. So also people asking why don't use traditional text search operators. We have for years like, ILike, and text operator, but they don't provide any linguistic support. What does it mean? It doesn't mean that you don't know what is a word, what to index, which kind of words to index. They don't know some linguistic like word normalization, stop words, and also no ranking. So results of the results documents are equally similar to query if you use traditional search engines. In 9.3, we got index support for some queries using PGTRGM. And here is the example of this query. Do you know how to? You can test it. So it can be used like a simple full text search engine. But I would not recommend it. So actually, full text search described on this slide. We have two data types, TS vector. TS vector is a data type for document, which optimized for searching. It's a sorted array of lexemes with some positional information and structural information. We call it weights. And another data type is TS query. TS query is a textual data type for query. It can contain grouping, logical operators, and so on. And we have a full text search operator. It's a 2@. So, and a bunch of functions. And so actually, full text search in Postgres is two data types and one operator. Other functions, indexes, is just additional stuff for make your life more comfortable. So what is the benefit of using full text search? Because document process only once. When you insert to table, you parse into tokens using pluggable parsers. Tokens converted to lexemes using dictionaries, pluggable also dictionaries. And word coordinates, position in the word in the document, in importance stored and used for ranking. So we optionally can ignore stop words. So, and query process in search time. So it's the same. Query parse in the tokens, process by dictionaries, and remove stop words. And also you can restrict search area using the weight labels. So if you have one index, actually you can provide many different searches for the subjects, for the bodies, for the authors, using just one index. And also, full text search provides possibility to rewrite query on the go without re-indexing. So in summary, full text search is a quite flexible search engine, but it is not a complete solution. It is a collection of bricks. I always said that you can use different pluggable parts to construct your own search engine. For example, you can easily write custom parser. So if you don't like default parser, you can write yourself parser. We have example in the source code, so just write. We have custom dictionaries, and dictionaries is just a program. It's you can write your own dictionary for your own problem. I know that some people use our full text search for indexing chemical formula, for example. They had own parser, dictionaries, and query looks like, please find me documents which contain some chemical formula. I don't can say about chemistry, but I was very surprised. And some people used for searching for genome strings also. So in principle, it is possible to customize our full text search in many, many ways. But of course, there are some problems. And the problem number one is that it is slow. But actually, if you see the explain analyze, you can see that searching is fast. It's just 13 milliseconds. The heap is slow. So we have this problem. If we eliminate heap from the search, we can be very fast. This is one problem. Example, it's just remember this number. It's a half of seconds to search 100 Wikipedia articles. Yes, it's the problem one is slow. The problem two is that there is no phrase search because so searching for A and B is equivalent to searching for B and A. Sometimes people wants to specify the order, and it is very desirable feature. And it's possible to use some hacks like combination of full text search and additional clause like regular expressions. It works in very simple cases, and usually it is slow. So FTS problem number three. Recently, maybe one or two times a year in mailing list, somebody asking about us how to order results of full text search by not rank, but by some other attribute. For example, people want to order by timestamp. This is a very desirable feature. Of course, it is possible to do, but naive way like this, we had, again, not very fast. It's like a, this is about Tom Lane. Yes, I was wondering what Tom Lane did against the new year in 2000 year. So this is like a KNN with full text search. Interesting to see that Tom Lane just before was working just before New Year and after. Yes, and it takes.
Slight sidebar. Do you have this database posted somewhere? I've been meaning to download.
Yes. It's very easy to download. We have a mailing list archive. And Thomas Wondra wrote special script, Python script, which download all everything, synchronize and indexing and put it to database.
Is there a SQL
dump
posted somewhere?
Or? Yes, I can give you a link. It's live in GitHub. So I download more all database archive. It's full up to May. It contains, do you know how many posting in our mailing list archive? What's your guess? It's about 1,100,000 postings total. So not much, but it's very good for playing, yes, this. And
like one post for every line of code in Postgres.
Yes, good.
and Tom Lane sent a fifth of them.
Tom Lane sent, yeah, fifth, yes, of 2,700, yes. Yeah.
This is believable,
yes. Yes.
That was the saddest task.
It's actually, I believe, it's where Tom Lane was mentioned. It was answers to Tom Lane.
Yes.
Which is almost every.
Yeah. And so I specially took Tom Lane because he's a very good example of how to search a large amount of results, non-selective query. Yes. So full text search problem number four. It connects with some that we have. We support dictionaries, but people bother about dictionaries. You need to find somewhere, download, install, and not everybody has a qualification to do this, because you should be understand if this dictionary is okay for you, is it working, and so on. Some, it's not easy. Dictionaries also loaded into memory for every session. So we have problem that first query is always slow. You see the number? For to load Russian Hanspiel dictionary 10 times, we spent about 4 seconds. This is ridiculously slow. But of course, next queries will be very fast, so no problem. But always people say, first query was because it's slow to memory. And it's not also slow, but it also eat memory. So you know that Russian Hanspiel dictionary occupy about 20 megabytes of memory. If you have 100 active sessions, it's about 2 gigabytes of memory. It wastes memory. So this is another problem of number four. Of course, there are always more other problems, but we will not concentrate on them. We will work with this. So first, we want to improve GIN, because GIN index is most useful and most useful for full text search. And as Alexander already said, 4 years ago, we, for 9.2, we suggested several patches for GIN. And actually, two of them was committed. And another is storing additional information in posting tree. For example, we can store the lexem positions or timestamps or other attributes and use that information for the other results. That will make possible to calculate, for example, ranking inside index, don't consult heap, and return results in desirable order. And effect is very, very interesting. So this is a slide for people who don't know what is GIN. GIN is actually any scientific book has on the last has an index, GIN index. You see there, this is the entry tree, it's lexemes, and this list of pages, number of pages, is a posting list. So if we convert this structure to the Postgres, we will get this one. Entry tree is a B-tree, and posting tree is also B-tree. So actually, GIN is some version of B-tree, optimized for storing duplicates. Very simple. Yeah, forest of B-trees, yes, very simple. So what we suggested? We suggested to Alexander to store not just item pointer. Here's the item pointer, which lives in the leaves of this B-tree, but add some additional information. And this additional information can be positional information or timestamp or other. And then we'll be very happy. This is a Pandora box. What, why, when Alexander Korotkov patch was committed, I immediately said that 9.6 opens the Pandora box. Generic val and custom access method, yes. I immediately said that 9.6 opens the Pandora box. So now any developer can write the custom access methods without spending, wasting time to convince community and convince community and, you know, yes, it's sometimes it's very good when you discussing some stuff with community, but sometimes it's you just don't have time, you have to solve your problem. So now you can just write custom access method. And you know this is a Pandora box.
Yes, I understand.
Yes, yeah. Yeah. So we decided now we have open, we have possibility to write our custom method using our four years old code. And we need just to take some name. So the name is RAM or ROM, how to pronounce, I don't know. In Russia, we say ROM. Why ROM? Because we have gin and we have vodka. It's something in the middle, it's a ROM.
ROM is a step on the way to vodka.
Yes, yeah. I don't know how to, yes, I don't know.
Unified method.
Or maybe random. Random. Yeah, so it's called just ROM. So we can now have a create index using ROM. We store, we use positional information to calculate rank and order result by rank. And also we introduce operator distance. Distance between the TS vector and TS query. This is very similar to the KNN. We use it's also the same. And
actually it's inverted to rank.
Yes. Distance, yeah. So if you remember the query, the previous query was run for 400 milliseconds. Now it runs just 14 milliseconds. Yeah. So this is, I think, this is a great win because if you read the mailing list archive, you see that people speed up query for 30%. People say, okay, okay. Here we have 100%, yes? Just because of additional information.
There is sorting node at all, index.
Because
ROM index can return the item pointers in the right order without sorting.
Yeah. So we did an experiment on real data because synthetic data often provide incorrect results. So we got six million of classified from the famous Russian company and did experiments. We use with vanilla Postgres, Postgres with Patch or and Sphinx, which is open source engine, which is free from transactions and so on. It should be very fast. And actually this slide is 4 years old. We just did add some new information. So 4 years old, we run queries 8 hours and calculate how many queries we process. So vanilla Postgres. ROM, yes. This was 3 million. With our patch, 4 years ago, was 42 million. And Sphinx that time, 4 years ago, was able to process only 32 million queries. Now with room, we see gin vanilla Postgres becomes 27 million. It's almost 9 times speed up. This is a result of 2 patches which submitted for 9.4. It's a gin compression and what else for 9.4? No. For this vanilla, we get increased because we gin becomes used optimization for fast scan and compression. So fast scan and compression gives you 9 time increment. Vanilla, and room provides slightly the same performance. It's faster than vanilla Postgres, but not as four years ago. Yeah. Yes. Yeah, yes. This is a machine quite powerful, 24 cores and 64 gigabytes of memory. So all database lives in memory. And the benefit of ROM index is not remarkable. But if your database doesn't fit the memory, this should be more remarkable. Yeah, so for another data set, we take a 20 million description and make the same. We see that vanilla Postgres can process 95 million of query. Room is 136 million, and Sphinx is 59 million. We don't know how to explain why Sphinx is so slow. So we need to analyze a bit more. But I like these numbers. Yeah, I think that Sphinx has a limit of 4 gigabytes of memory. It can't use more than 4 gigabytes of memory. Yes, 4 or 2 gigabytes. So probably it just doesn't fit to memory. Yeah. Okay, so full text search is slow. We a bit now have solution. Now we go to the phrase search. Phrase search is actually 8 years old. First we published 8 years ago phrase search. It was already available, but that time people was not very, you know, enthusiastic, and so we did not try to commit to the Postgres. But with time, Postgres becomes more popular. Full text search become more popular. People asking us about phrase search, so we just took old patch, dust, and made some improvements. So what is the phrase search? I already said that A and B and B and A is produce the same results. But for phrase search, you preserve order of words. So results for A and B and A should be very different. We introduce new phrase operator. I don't know how to say it, phrase distance or what.
Phrase end,
yes. Because it is guarantee order of operands, and it guarantee the distance between operands. Here is a, if you like some math, you can read
definition.
This. Definition.
Operations mean that in document should be A, should be B, and should exist a position between A and B that is less than N.
Mm-hmm. No. If you see the A and B, I say that A phrase and B. It's difficult. So the definition is that this operator returns false. If false, then nothing to return. And if true, it returns the positions of the right operand, which satisfies the distance condition. So if TS vector does not contain any position information, this operator will be equivalent to normal end operator.
Fallback.
Yeah, fallback. And this is A and B is not the same as B and A. So phrase search looks very simple, but actually it's not. Because if you see the properties, we see this queries, you can write like A, phrase N, B, phrase M, C. It matches the phrase length less than.
Look, actually, the operation end phrase B will calculate all position of B which satisfies this clause. And so then it will be next calculate B and C with this
distance. Yes.
It's yeah. Not very intuitive, but it's.
Yeah. Yeah, and. and you know that dictionary.
Some later Alex will explain
Yeah, and you know that dictionary can return not just one infinitive, it can return more. So we have a zero, it matches the words with two different forms. So this is example.
In English, it's not very common case, but in Russian.
In Russian language or.
German, Norwegian.
Yeah.
It's, very
you can, yeah. Here's the example. For example, we provide function phrase two-task query. It's like two-task query, it's just simplify. You don't write your distances calculate because it's you do this for you. Select phrase two-task query. PostgreSQL can be extended by user in many ways. You see this the result. And you can see that number three, distance three. It's a can be is treated as a stop words. So we have Postgres extend and the distance is free. So we took into account stop words, position of stop words. Okay.
How did it change the spelling of many?
Because of the dictionary, it's not me.
It's not me.
Actually, it's a snowball stammer. It's a snowball stammer. It's change Y now to I. Sky, ski, it's, I don't know. Yeah, so here is some. Yeah, sky and ski. Yeah. So ask Martin Porter. It's Martin Porter's. Yeah. Phrase search.
I'm not a native speaker, but ask a lot of native speakers about that. Okay?
Yeah. So.
Actually, that was in the Russian dictionary. it was a Russian dictionary that led to that, to the, those stemmings?
Because English.
No, it's impossible. We don't use alphabet. This alphabet.
Yeah.
Russian stemming.
Yeah. So as you understand, phrase search has overhead because it has to work with coordinates. We need to take coordinates, process, do some calculation. So we want to reduce this overhead. Okay. Let's consider this example. It's not easy. This query, you can write this query tree. And we want to avoid slowdown of. Давай по быстрому.
Do you remember I explained how operator phrase operator works 2 slides ago, and you see that in this tree we need the usual operator or which usually don't take into account the position. In this case, it should you take. Count position, calculate the list, and
provide positions to the upper operator.
Yes. So we don't want to do that, of course.
And we do transformation of search. So from this query, we obtain this query, which has a very nice property that it optimizes access to the position information. For example, this query does not need any positions. All positions works only in this so-called phrase tree.
And actually, it uses a separate executor. So on top query, it works executor already existed. If it finds the phrase operation, then it calls the special phrase executor, which pay attention to positions.
To give some real life example, we have query close galaxies and some astronomical dictionary return instead of galaxy, return Andromeda galaxy, Magellanic Cloud, and so on. And then phrase becomes very, very complicated. So it's very easy. And then you get such a query tree, and this query tree optimized for the calculation. Example of our transformation. we don't want to stay about push down. Okay, here is a very interesting query. Can you interpret this A and not B? So we transform to this. This you can understand. So there is no B which close to A. Yes?
Yeah. That's how I read it. So B cannot follow A directly.
Yes. But in this form is easy to calculate. Because you don't need, it's not B is very difficult to process in index.
You need to go to all other
positions. So this is an example of push down. And okay, we'll miss. So here's the example, phrase search. Again, 1 of 1 million postings. And we're looking for the Tom Lane. Okay, he was right. It's one-fifth of queries. And sequential scan. We have a 1.7 second to find. And if you use not a phrase operator, but just plain end, Tom end lane, you get just 1.6 second. So sequential scan more or less okay. There is not much overhead. For the gene index, you see the different position. Gene index has big overhead, 1.1 second, a bit faster, but plain end operator provides less than half of second. So we see the overhead of because we use recheck. We don't, gene index has no positional information, it should recheck. And recheck is very costly. And now room index. Room index has almost no overhead because of all our optimization and coordinate information. Yes, we see half second and yes. Okay, number two, we got solution. Another is a inverse full text search. Sometimes you want to find not the document, but you want to find a query which can be used to find the document. So this is inverted full text search. This is the example from real life is a subscription service. If in our mailing list somebody registered a query about multi-master something, blah, blah, blah. Yes. So you can easily find the documents. You see, or you can use for automatic text classification. Here's the example. This query tag, and I want to classify this TS vector. Black holes never exist before we think about them. And I see that it's about color. So automatic classification. And we provide also a room index for this kind of search. It's very interesting example that we store additional information, not positions, but we store branches of query tree. And that provides us a possibility to use room index. It's another example. And here is an interesting example. You know which query we can use to find the first posting in our mailing list archive? The first posting, you can use this PostgreSQL and FreeBSD query, and you will find the first message. It was by Mark Fournier. Mark Fournier, he loves FreeBSD, so it's fine. And another example, I tried to mine our mailing list archive to find the first okay, this is another. This is monstrous postings. We have very spam posting. For example, you see, there are more than 4,000 queries can be find this package patch, this very big posting post. I don't know details, but you see it's I understand that when we discuss release notes, it can be very popular. But package patch was very, and this query runs about 1 hour. 1 hour. So it was like a join, you know, 1 million postings and 30,000 of queries. And queries are real life. I got from the Magnus. I don't remember years ago. It's real life queries from the PostgreSQL.org site. So now we have a problem number three. So what if you want to order results of full text search by timestamp? Yes. So what we can do? We can just store timestamp in additional information and use it to order. Another example of room. Also, we can order posting tree list by timestamp, not by item pointer, but timestamp. So it's this is we hope to do in Ottawa, but we were busy, so it's not yet. But there is no problem, no principal problem. Yeah, but we did this. Here is the example, and we got you see very substantial speed up. The same query about Tom Lane. What Tom Lane did at near the New Year. Okay.
5 minutes more.
Yeah. So here is our to-do. What else? So we want to order postings not by item pointer. And in our estimates, it gives you 30 or 50% speed up again. And we want to allow multiple additional info. For example, if you want to have a phrase search with timestamp. So we need a positional information and timestamp. So this is also doable. We need to fix some not very important limitation. We can add op classes for array, so we can calculate similarity and for integer float. Improve ranking function to support TF-IDF, finally, because people are asking about why your ranking function doesn't support TF-IDF. But it's because we need storage to store IDF information. Now, if we have additional information, we can store there. Dictionaries as extension. No, very, very fast. There is a GitHub repository. You can just now create extension dictionary, and it's available to you, so you can use. And dictionaries in shared memory. So now you can create, create a dictionary, which will live in shared memory, so you will not have a problem with the first time query. You see, optimization. Before it was about 4 seconds, and now it's just negligible. And you optimize memory usage. Mm-hmm. Another improvement is committed to the 9.6. It's patch by Stas Kielovich from Postgres Pro. It's a TS vector editing function. Yes, there are a bunch of functions you can use. Sometimes they are. Very useful, yes, but we have no time. Yes, okay, so thanks. Yeah, if you have questions, we are ready to answer. Yeah.
So you showed us with a lot of the Rome stuff. So two questions with this. One is that you showed us a lot of the Rome stuff. What's in core 9.3 right now in terms of phrase search? I was a little unclear on that. 9.6.
Just phrase search.
Okay.
Just with phrase search, but it works, but you see the overhead. Mm-hmm. No, we hope that the ROM will be available this release. We now free. We can do our development independently.
There is no performance degradation from this new feature.
Another thing is, on the slides, you were showing us the one operator for distance.
Yes.
But in the run documentation, it's a different operator.
Yeah.
It's actually different operators, or you change the operator? The run has the greater than, less than operator.
We just changed yesterday. Yesterday. Because semantically, it's like a distance.
Yeah. And the other distance operator looks like this way.
I don't know how to speak, how to tell in English. How?
Two side arrow.
Two side. Yes.
Yeah.
So how do you manage, I don't know if it's part of this or at a higher level, but Unicode case folding and normalization for search, is it part of the full text search?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, so it's part, but it's old part.
Yeah, we did it many years ago. It's we support Unicode.
Right, in last 4 or 5 years, there wasn't
any problem with it?
Any improvements except it's loading dictionary into memory and so on.
Sorry for the
sharing.
You're talking about the Unicode case fold. You have that built in to the full text search?
Yes.
Okay.
No problem.
More questions?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.